I play Spencer, and he's top dog on the wing, if you like. He's the daddy. He's still actively working as a criminal within the system, and anything that disrupts that, there's consequences. So he's allowed to operate within the system just to keep the peace, really. And someone like Jack O'Connell's character, Eric Love, is a very volatile disruption. And it's something that he doesn't want to jeopardize his work ethic and how he likes to run the wing. And there's quite dire sort of consequences for people that misbehave. He's quite a forceful character. He's quite a cunning character that works within the system. I'd say blatantly evil, but I think he's just someone that he's developed a way of working in the prison as opposed to outside, and it's a matter of survival, really. It's a matter of being in control and having the power to control his life within the system. And Jack's character is very volatile and very tormented individual, and that causes a lot of problems for my character. He was very hardworking. He threw himself into the movie 100%. It's a very physical role for Jack. So he was, every day he had to do something that was extremely physical and demanded a lot from him. And he gave it 110%. He was great. He's a very passionate, hardworking actor. I think he'll do really well from this film. Yeah.
What was it overall about Jonathan's script that interested you, and what do you think an audience is going to take away from the film as a whole?
I think it's a really authentic depiction of prison life, and it's not just about a load of male testosterone throwing their weight around. There's a message to this film, and it's Jonathan obviously works in the prison system as a psychotherapist and having to deal with people with anger issues or drug problems, and it addresses those issues. And at the heart of it, you've got a father and son that are coming together for the first time in a long time, where their relationship has been severed, it's been broken, and this is a chance for them to make or break their relationship. So there's a real strong message there about reconnecting and forgiving and moving forward and love. I think it's a love story. It is a love story between a father and son, and it's very heartfelt. And there's some really poignant emotional scenes in the film that show that. You know, it's not all about boys being boys. It's a really heartfelt movie. It's quite an emotional roller coaster, I think. Yeah. So working within a real prison was very beneficial, because you're not on a set, you're in a real location, and it's a real prison. It was cold, it was damp, and it was quite horrid, but it added to it the effect, and it added to everyone's performance, I think. It just made it more authentic and more real, and it just created a wonderful place to work, really, because it just made your job a lot easier. You know, you're not worrying about green screens or sets falling down or doors shaking, and everything was solid and real, and that was very helpful as an actor.
What's next for you?
I finished a movie just for Christmas called Hyena. It's directed by Gerard Johnson, and I'm the lead in that, and that's a cop thriller based in London, and that's with Stephen Graham, Miana Baring, Neil Maskell. So that'll be out later this year. And I've just worked with Ben Wheatley again, which I can't really talk too much about. I did his last movie, The Field, in England, but I just worked with him again, which was really cool. That's about it at the moment.